I'm going to show you a really quick and fun way to make consistent shadows in any digital drawing app. Hi, I'm Ashton Rodenizer. I have a business called Mind's Eye Creative, and I primarily do graphic recording, graphic facilitation, and I also teach people how to sketchnote. So today I'm actually going to be using the app called Sketchbook Pro. But as long as you're using a drawing app that allows you to have layers, you can use this these tips in any of those drawing apps to make shadows. So I'm gonna hop on my computer here and we're gonna get going. Okay, so we are looking at my favorite drawing program, which is called Sketchbook Pro. You should be able to use this same technique in any drawing program as long as you have the layering function, which I'll cover here in a minute. So I'm just gonna start by writing out my word. So because we are doing a shadow, I'm gonna write out the word shadow for fun. Okay, so there's our word shadow. And what we're going to do is there's this little icon over here with the three paper squares, and we're gonna open that. Okay, it might look different. Depending on what program you're using, it might have a different icon, but you can search in the help section to help you find where the layering of feature is. And it should look something similar to this, may or may not have a background, but you can see here that we have shadow on layer one. Now you can layer those, or you can rename those layers if you want, if you end up having a lot of layers, but maybe I'll cover that in a future video more about layering. So what we're going to do is we're going to hold on to our pen. We're just holding our pen down, and you can see there's a bunch of options here. So we're going to go and duplicate the layer like this. And now it doesn't look like anything has changed, but if we go to our quick transform tool, it's called, and I'm just going to bring this down so you can see it. And we've got this entire layer. Then we're going to move it, and you can kind of see it's moving around. But you can see the original one that we did is standing still because we're only moving this one layer that we copied. Now, if you don't have a duplicate layer feature, which I'd be surprised if you didn't, but if you didn't have one, then you could go to any of your type of like highlight tools and then go copy and paste, and then it should create it on a new layer. Okay, let's get rid of that. All right. So you can see here that I put, it's a little bit tricky to see because I still have it in the same color, but I've moved this up like so. You could change the color first if you wanted to, but I'm gonna do it this way because this is how I normally do it. And then I'm actually gonna go back and select the first layer because that's the one behind this one, and I'm gonna recolor it. So if I'm gonna do like a light purple. So I'm just gonna go to my color and just choose a light, and then I'm gonna go to my fill option, and then I'm just gonna click on each letter. Look at that. Now you have a shadow, very quick, with very great proportions. It's landing exactly where it's supposed to be. Once you have it colored, so you can see the difference. You can choose either layer, and then you can play with it a little bit more. Let's say if you wanted the shadow above, or if you want it on the other side, you can position it however you want. I always like it on this side for some reason, I'm not sure. So you don't always have to do it just for letters. You could do it for absolutely anything. If you draw a face and you want to have it a shadow, or any icons or whatever it is that you're doing. If you want to lock those two together so they don't move around, then we're just going to merge them. So again, we're going to hold on to our layer, and it says merge with below or merge all. So if you had a whole graphic that you wanted to merge everything together, you could do that all and merge all if you ended up having like a bunch of layers. We're just gonna merge with below for now, just for fun. And then if we move it around, you can see they have stuck together. So there you go. There's a nice, fun, easy way to make shadows in Sketchbook Pro. All right, now go forth and make easy shadows. I hope you enjoyed this little tip. If you'd like to see more of these types of videos, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell if you want to be notified on future videos. And if you want to go and learn how to Sketchnote, you can go and get a free guide that I have at sketchnote101.com and pick up your own free copy there. And looking forward to see you on the next video, and have an amazing day.